What is exactly a simp? Well, according to its definition on Urban Dictionary, someone who does way too much for a person they like. In other words, by donating tons of money to streamers, mostly females, to try to get into a relationship which at the end will never work that way. Nowadays, people are being called a simp for helping a girl or maybe trying to save her life from whatever catastrophe is coming to their path. It has lost its meaning throughout these months because apparently doing any action that involves with a girl is considered simping instead of the actual definition of simp. Don't get me wrong, if you're donating to a female streamer to support their channel and their top-notch quality stream, then that's fine. You're just a normal fan. You don't have any intent to buy your way to get a girlfriend by simping. Anyways, besides that, why do these people donate large amounts of money to these female streamers? Well, obviously, I already answered in the introduction, to get into a relationship. But that's way too simple. Pretend that you're a Twitch streamer and a fan has donated $1,000 to you. For your reaction, you'll be shocked because a person literally gave you so much money because they enjoyed your content. But sometimes they'll leave a message alongside with that donation, and you tend to read these messages out of respect. Since these simps know that large amounts of donations attract people's attention, then they know they can get any female streamer's attention by donating either $100 or even $10,000. On top of that, they can attach their message where they express their love to whatever particular female streamer they're donating to, trying to see if they can get into a romantic relationship. 90% of the time, this never worked because these female streamers don't even know who these donors are in the first place. They haven't even spoken to these female streamers behind the scene, which put these female streamers in an uncomfortable position after reading maybe an essay on why they love them, despite them not actually speaking or knowing these female streamers in real life. But at least what these people are doing is legal rather than doing the extreme. Another thing that's also an issue to female streamers is stalking. Like, most creeps will pinpoint the coordinates on where the female streamers are, and they could possibly try to stalk them IRL. Angels Kimmy, a popular Twitch streamer with over 299,000 followers, had addressed this issue on her stream where these people will create servers dedicated to stalking streamers on their whereabouts, and servers filled with inappropriate Photoshop images of female streamers.
There have been Discords going around, which basically are filled with like Photoshopped images of girl streamers like myself that are very inappropriate. So that's like one example. We basically find these Discords and see basically like all the people who are in it, the people who created it, and we ban them all throughout like everyone's streams, right? There's also Discords that like are devoted to stalking streamers, or like they post their IRL like whereabouts and stuff like that. So those people in those Discords are also banned across everyone's streams.
Another example I would like to share is a Redditor who loved this particular female streamer way too much. In his post, he talks about this female streamer he'd grown to like her for a while now. But he found out that this female streamer actually lived in the same city, and his objective is to meet up with this girl and to ask her out. OP then talks about how pretty she is and how he likes her personality. Just normal stuff. Until he talks about this particular part. This streamer's social media has her doing pretty basic stuff like going out to eat and going to the gym. I suppose the simple thing would be to go to the gym that she goes to, but most people I know only go to the gym to work out for themselves and don't care to flirt and meet potential dates there. My plan right now is to apply jobs at vitamin and nutrient stores that I suspect her of going to, these stores being right by the gym she goes to, but there's no guarantee I'll get hired, nor is there a guarantee that she even goes there. This has sparked a massive outrage because this guy wants to stalk this particular female streamer. People were responding to OP that he shouldn't be stalking. One Redditor suggested that he should maybe try sending a DM to one of her socials. However, he declined this advice and still stick with his stalking plan. A couple hours later, he disappeared from the internet. There's one unfortunate situation that I want to share with you all. Meet this particular Twitch streamer, Sweet Anita, and right now as we speak, her stalker is still on the loose, threatening her life. This all started back in November 7th, 2019, where she revealed in her tweet that her stalker was caught and detained. So she had to cancel tonight's stream that day to give a statement and evidence to the police. Ricky Burick asked if this was an online stalker, to which Anita replied, "Sadly, I have a fair amount of online stalkers, but this one was IRL. He spent hours outside my house, he even slept behind my house, and managed to assault me. I've been harassed for a month now, and I'm relieved that something might be done about it." The next day, she had some unfortunate news. The stalker who was caught had a knife of him during the arrest, and yet was released with caution, even after Anita gave all the screenshots, recordings, a witness statement from her friend, and his confession to harassing her. Not only that, her stalker will move into a place that is 4 minutes away from her permanently. Jumping straight to April 8th, 2020, Anita shared her story about how her stalker physically assaulted her with further details on stream. But after enduring months of being through a nightmare, her stalker was punished with a suspended sentence to 2 months in prison and banned from visiting Anita's hometown.
The other day, some shopkeepers had to intervene and kind of hold him back while he chased after me, because he waited outside my house, followed me into a shop, then waited for me outside the shop, and when I told him to leave me alone and asked if he had a knife, he didn't respond. When I said, "Are you gonna let me walk home alone?" he said yes, and then when I went to cross the road, he started chasing, and two guys ran out of the shop and grabbed him, and then grabbed hold of the gate to another area of town, and so I went through the gate, and they held it closed so that he couldn't pass them and continue to follow me. It's not the worst thing he's done. He has actually physically assaulted me. So they said they were going to press charges for stalking. They took it to court in a day, so they held him overnight, and then the next day, I think they held him again, so I think they had him for 2 days because they kept him until the court date because they wanted to press charges for stalking. They pressed charges for stalking. He's been banned from visiting my town. So he's going to be escorted back to his guest house to collect his things. And then he has to just stay out of town and find somewhere new to stay. Because he's been sleeping in guest houses around my area within a 10-minute walk of my house. And every time the police caught him, he'd change to a new guest house so they wouldn't know where to find him if he'd left before the police arrived. And so he was just floating around near my house. He's been living in the town for a few months now.
Despite of this, on July 14th, Anita's plan didn't went accordingly. He didn't honor it, which means she'll be busy sorting things with the police. And on top of that, her stalker sent another death threat, saying he won't be bringing a cheap knife he had the last time, but something special to her. At the end, Anita was feeling hopeless because her police department had proven pretty much useless when it comes to her case, and that they didn't care at all. Stalking cases in general are sometimes not taken seriously by the local law enforcement. The only time they will usually act upon is if the stalker either kills the individual or inflicts harm upon them. In fact, Anita tweeted out an article from Vice that 55 British women were killed by their stalkers who previously reported to the police between 2015 and 2018. UK's police failed to understand the perspective from these women's point of view. The hell they had to endure every day from their stalker's death threats, or the feeling of being watched for months or maybe even years. However, Anita didn't just give up from there. Her new goal is to try gather up all other content creators and to help change the current online harassment laws so nobody can suffer the same fate that Anita went through.
I've decided that I'm going to actually take action, and I'm going to get as many content creators involved as possible. Okay, let's just change the law. Let's do it. There are enough of us. I'm sure no content creator wants to come in the line of fire and die for their content. So let's do this. I'm going to be making some plans in the coming days, putting together a video explaining why and the statistics and the incidents where the police have failed us, and we're gonna change this shit because, yeah, nobody deserves to go through this.
I would like to give a quick word of advice to the simps. Well, the people who are planning on donating female streamers, expecting a romantic relationship from it. Don't. It's literally a waste of money. Pretty much obvious from what I said, but I'll put this way. You see, you have to know or talk to that streamer in order for you to be in a relationship with that certain person. She needs to know who you are exactly, and if you guys have been talking for a while now. However, if you just donated tons of money or sent a message to confess your love without doing those things, you wasted your time and your money. Streamers are there to entertain you viewers like yourself. That's what they do as a streamer. They're not looking for a relationship with a complete stranger who has zero knowledge about you. Just move away from that and start talking to some girls on whatever besides Twitch streams. But remember this quote, there are plenty of fish in the sea, meaning that she isn't the only one. In fact, there are more just like her.